So then guys, I have here the brand new Mac Studio M1 Ultra variant, and inside this I actually have the 64 core version of this machine. And a lot of you guys out there are wondering, can you play Steam games on the likes of the new Mac Studio with an M1 Max or an M1 Ultra? And today I'm going to find that out for you. But just quickly, what I do want to mention right at the beginning of this video, I just want to tell you what this video is about. It literally is testing, can you play Steam games on a Mac Studio? Do they work? I'm not going to basically go over frames per second and comparing it to the likes of, say, an RTX 3090, for example, or a 3080 Ti. I'm not going to be doing that in this video. And with that, what I do want to show you is this webpage here. As you can see, there are quite a few games that are compatible on Mac, but not everything works. Now, there is the likes of using, say, Parallels and Crossover, and I'm sure there's lots of YouTube videos out there showing how that works and doing some trickery to make the games work from Windows over into Mac, but that's what I'm going to be doing today. I'm just going to be showing some Steam games that are fully compatible on Mac, and let's see how well they work on this Mac Studio. So without further ado, let's head over to the Mac Studio, power up Steam as you can see right here, and let's flick over and start recording on screen and see what we get. So I know I keep repeating myself here, but like I said, the purpose of this video is just to see that Steam games work on the new Mac Studio. I'm not going to be showing frames per second or things like this. I just want to see the actual game working itself. So we're going to load up some games here, going into the library. And I'm only going to show you guys four games today. We're going to start with Counter-Strike. It's always a good game to test out first of all. And this has been working on Macs for a while. I've done a little hack to make it all work in full screen. So we're going to play that first of all. And then after this, we're going to move over to Planet Coaster. Another game that's really good to test out the graphics with zooming in, doing some views of the game and things. And after this, we're going to do Rise of the Tomb Raider, a great game to demo, and Apple V. Even demo this working on M1 chipsets. And then finally, the last game we're going to test out is going to be Rocket League as well, to see how well that works on this Mac Studio. But first of all, let's go over to Counter-Strike and let's play this game as well. Let's click play. Let's see it load up. Might take a few seconds to load. Yep, it's going to go full screen. This always happens, you get a blank screen for a little bit. There we go, CSGO. And there we go, we're in the main menu. I'm going to just do a practice game on here. I'm rubbish at this, as you will see in a second. So I'm just going to select this with practice with bots. We'll do the standard dust too. Let's click go on this. Oh, is it going to work? I think it's worked. There we go. Yep. So game's just loading up now. Just wait for this to fully load up. I haven't played this game in such a long time. I'll be honest, I haven't played Counter-Strike probably like in about 15 years probably now. It's been absolutely ages since I've played this. But it's my favourite level as well. So let's see how well we are good at this. I'm deciding I'm going to be... yeah. Let's keep going. Let's do the counter-terrorists. Let's see how well then. Oh, this is really hard on the touchpad, guys. I will tell you that. It's really, really... oh, see, look at that. I'm not even concentrating. Touchpad, I hate it. Yeah, do not play this on a touchpad. I don't know even why I've got my touchpad connected up to this Mac Studio with the Bluetooth one. I like using the touchpad because I use it for Final Cut Pro, but yeah, for playing games on it, it's awful. Don't use a touchpad, whatever you do. Yeah, look up. Oh, yeah, there we go. We got him. We got him. But yeah, talk about the game though. It looks like it's working absolutely fine. No problems whatsoever switching around weapons and everything. If you just really want to just quickly jump into this game, you're not really going to have any problems at all. I think it's a great game. But let's just come out of it then. And let's go over then to the next game. So I'm just going to quit this. Let's go down here. Quit to the desktop. There we go. And then let's move on to Planet Coaster next of all. Let's press play here. And let's see this game load up now. Oh, another play button. Why do I have to play it twice? I have no idea. But anyway, so we're loading up. Just give it a bit of a go. See how quickly this loads. It should be quite quick. This game is one of my old favourites again. I used to be a massive fan of Roller Coaster Tycoon back in the day. That was 2D graphics. But I think Planet Coaster is a fantastic game to actually play. So let's just get through this. This big guy jumps into the frontier and everything. Oh, falls over. Let's just load up the game. So first of all, what we're going to do is let the world load up. There we go. Look how good that is, the graphics with that. Let's go to play. We're going to do a sandbox, I believe. Let's do it in tropical as well. That'll be good. Yeah, we'll just do that at start now. I've just realised the sound's not on. Oh, gosh. Sorry, guys. Let me turn on the sound. There we go. Sound's back on again. My apologies about that. It's taking a little longer, probably because it's the first time, but there we go, we're in. Oh, again, using a trackpad, a very, very bad idea. Oh gosh, I really need a mouse for this. I should have used a mouse straight away. But let's go to my blueprints here. There's a Spinball Wizard coaster here. I'm going to park this in here. And let's put that in, for example. Voila! I need to readjust my mouse. I have no idea what the touchpad things are here. But as you can see, it's built. And let's just do a quick test on that one. It's doing a test run at the moment. I actually want to see what it looks like. I can't remember where you have to go to now. I haven't played this game in so long. To actually view what everything looks like. There we go. Ride camera. There we go. This is a Spinball Wizard sort of thing. So this level, this actually kind of track layout, I think, is from a park in my country, actually, called Alton Towers, as this track layout. But as you can see, it works absolutely fine. Let's go from a person's point of view, or near them. That's the best of you. That works absolutely fine. The graphics, it's not struggling whatsoever. I don't see any lacking sort of frames per second or anything. I think the game is working perfectly on that one. So yeah, that is really, really, really cool. In fact, I'm going to come out of it now. So over to Tomb Raider, and specifically Rise of the Tomb Raider, and a game I love and haven't played in ages as well. So yeah, look out for my rubbish effort here. If I remember now, I've got to raise the water. I know she's just said it as well, but yeah. Oops. Falling over there. Let's just get over. If I remember now. Here. I can't remember where I have to go now. Just got to remember. Yeah, can I shoot it down? Let's give it a go. Don't think I can get it from. Might be able to get it. Yeah. Nope, that's not really done anything. But you can see here, guys, the game is working superb here. It really, really works well. Look how good the graphics is. I know that Apple have actually showed off this game before. So look at the wet textures on her as well, even. It's really, really good for what you're getting with the M1 Ultra inside this Mac Studio. So yeah, it's definitely playable. I am going to say that. Whether it's the best, I wouldn't actually agree. But it's good to see it all working fine. So the last game to look at is Rocket League, and let's just get that powered up and all ready to go. So we're going to click play here. Let's do a seasonal exhibition. Let's do that. And let's just create a match. And see how rubbish I am on this game as well, because it's been ages since I've actually played this one as well. So let's just load this one up. I'm going to just do an auto join. And booster. Is it a goal? Oh, look at that, straight in. But you can see that works straight away. What I'll do is this time though, I think I'll just won't do that. I'll show you the game actually working a bit better this time without me just shooting the ball around, even though it is a one-on-one. There we go. But you can see everything works okay. We can change it to the different view here. So yeah, it looks absolutely awesome. And I can just hit the ball around. I'm just trying to find where the other player is now. I think I put one on one. I just can't see him anywhere. But yeah, everything looks absolutely cool. You can see here I'm pressing all the random keys that I should be playing. But the game is running awesomely here. And yes, you can see that basically games that are completely native to work on a M1 or M1 Pro, M1 Max, or even now the M1 Ultra, you can see they work absolutely fine. But like I said, there isn't that many variety of games out there, and personally, I would not be buying this Mac Studio just to buy Steam games. It is not for this. You are far better off, I'm going to say, in buying yourself a gaming PC instead. But it's good to know that the odd couple of games do work. So there we have it. There were four games, as you can see, that worked absolutely perfectly on this Mac Studio. I didn't have time really to configure and change graphic settings. I bet I could. The likes of CSGO, for example, I bet you I can make the graphics even better on that. Same with like Planet Coaster, to be honest, all the games. But overall, as you can see, the Mac Studio can play games. But would you buy one to play games on? Absolutely not. I would definitely not say buy one of these to play games on. You're far better off buying yourself a gaming PC instead. Mac Studios are not designed to be gaming machines, so do not buy one for this reason. What I would say is though, if you just want to have a few games on your machine, as you are a creator, a bit of time to relax, and you just want to quickly power up a game, then yeah, that's what this is for. It's worth knowing that you can install a few games on your Mac Studio. Well, with that, guys, it's time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please also make sure you hit the subscribe button, follow my notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Bye bye.